You shall look through the other side to penetrate by vision, to look fixedly and to see clearly as a blind man recovering sight. You shall discern with the bodily eye and gaze upon Christ, having the power of understanding. Beware, Yehoshua declares, I counsel thee, buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, and white raiment, that thou mayest be clothed, and that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear, and anoint thine eyes with eye salve, that they mayest see. You shall see with your eyes him who uttered the voice, and you shall have free access to him as princes, ministers, and personal friends have to a king, as angels of the closest access and of the highest rank. You shall perceive by the senses, discern mentally, and observe the omniscient God, seeing in secret where man sees nothing. By certain external signs we see from his resurrection and from the effects and witness of the Holy Spirit, we shall see Jesus crowned. Weigh carefully, ponder, and evaluate what is said. Pay close attention and watch cautiously. Examine, inquire, inspect, and vet it. Look to Christ to provide and take care of you. Because of this reason, carry this message through. Announce it everywhere, through places, through assemblies of men. Publish it abroad. Declare and preach it to signify or be a sign to all who were in the temple and were possessing knowledge of the sequence of events referred to. An envoy, an angel, messenger of God, one of the heavenly spirits that wait upon the monarch of the universe and are sent by him to earth now to execute his purposes, to make them known to men. Angels, messengers of God, bring tidings. They shall drive, propel, and transport the company, a military unit, guests, and companions, to lead us. The angels shall take a nation by laying hold of us, and in this way bring us to the point of destination, the court of justice, to keep and celebrate the feast. We shall go and depart by means of and through this intervention. Time has elapsed and passed, and this shall come to pass. When it happens, events shall be made finished, miracles shall be performed, prophecy shall be fulfilled, and we shall be married. Because of this reason, we shall be distinguished, characterized by excellence, made noble and dignified in appearance, famous and celebrated. In a legal sense, we shall be examined closely and judged to be distinguished and known accurately when he determines and decides our case. We shall know and understand when we become known. Find a sign in this by which to know and recognize the truth of this promise. You shall be recognized as worthy of intimacy and love, whom Yah has judged worthy of the blessings of the gospel. Because of this, watch through, remain awake, be fully awake. Overcome the force of sleep by which you were weighed down. Be fully awake, watch, give strict attention, be cautious and active. Take heed lest through remission and indolence some destructive calamity suddenly overtake you. Be vigilant lest you be led to forsake Christ, or lest you fall into sin or be corrupted by errors. Be watchful, employ the most punctilious care in watching. Be aroused from sleep, awaken, arise from the sleep of death. He will recall the dead to life and cause them to appear, bringing them before the public, and he will stir us up, causing us to be born, collecting our faculties, gathering us in the assembly of the elect. By means of and through these events, we shall be led through and sent across to the other side, allowed to pass, to live, and to lead a life of the living. You shall be taken by laying hold of you to bring you to the point of destination, the court of justice, the magistrate, to keep and celebrate the feast. Because of this reason, we shall be given a diadem, a kingly ornament for the head, a crown or corona, in the sense of a chaplet, wreath or garland. This is the badge of victory in the games, of civic worth, of military valor, of nuptial joy, and of festal gladness. At Christ's coronation, we shall be bound and put under obligation of law and duty to be bound to Christ as a wife to a husband. Because of this, he shall distribute and divide his goods among us. He shall give over, deliver, and distribute to us, bestowing gifts to grant, supply, and furnish us with necessary things. Reach out, and he shall present in writing to entrust and commit something to be managed and administered, something to be religiously observed. He shall give us what is due or obligatory, to pay wages or reward, to furnish and do and hand out lots. He shall cause the sea, death, and hell to give up and bring forth the dead who have been engulfed or received by them. And you shall be given to Christ as his own, as an object of his saving care, to follow him as a leader and master, to return us to him. Pour into your bosom, put upon your mind, fasten it in your heart, to go into this place and remain.